Hey everyone, welcome back to Practical AutoCAD and Inventor. If you're working with 3D models in Autodesk Inventor and want to share your designs in an interactive format, you're in the right place. In this video, I'll show you how to easily export your 3D designs as PDFs. Creating a 3D PDF will allow you to share your models with others who might not have access to Inventor, but still want to explore the design in a fully interactive way. Whether you're collaborating with team members or sharing with clients, a 3D PDF is an incredibly useful tool. By the end of this video, you'll be able to share your designs in a way that anyone can view and explore without needing specialized software. Let's get started. In preparation for creating this 3D PDF, there might be a few things that you want to do. For example, if I come up here to the File tab and I choose iProperties, you might want to come into the Summary tab and enter some information in here as far as title, subject, author, and so on. In fact, you'll see in a moment that all of these tabs have fields that could be included, if you wish, on the resulting PDF that will print at the end. The other thing that you might want to do is you might want to come in and add representations. So you'll see here that I've created a few different representations. I've got my default, isometric view here. I've also got a front view. I've got a right side view. I've got a rear view, okay? If there's any other special views that you want to show, or perhaps you want to remove some parts and create that representation, you can do that. So I'm gonna come back to my primary view here. And now I'm ready to create my 3D PDF. To do so, you'll go to the File tab. You'll come down here and you'll choose Export and then 3D PDF. This dialog box will give you all of the options that you'll need for creating your 3D PDF. Starting in the upper left-hand corner here, you'll see that I've got title, subject, author, keywords, and those kinds of things. So I'm going to leave those all in, except I'm not going to have them all in there. I don't need any keywords. I also don't necessarily need any of the document summary information. Except I do want, manager and company. So I'm going to leave those, but then I'm going to turn these off here, and I'll come down here at the bottom and I'll turn these off. So those are all the different things that you'll see in the iProperties dialog box. Over here, it has the views that I've created, those view representations, and I'm going to leave those in there as well. On this button right here, you can choose between low, medium, and high visualization quality. Remember that high creates a larger file and it takes longer to create. Okay, so if you want to keep it manageable, I'm just going to leave mine at medium there. On the template, because I am creating a 3D PDF of an assembly, I'm making sure that I use this assembly template. It's going to give me a little bit more flexibility here in just a few minutes that I'll show you. Okay. And then finally, where are you going to save this? And I'm going to save this just on my desktop so that it makes it easier for me to find later. And then I can choose publish. I do have this check mark right here. It's going to view the PDF when it's finished. So I'll choose publish. And then it's going to take a couple minutes to create my 3D PDF. Now that the 3D PDF has been completed, let's take a look at what it gives us. You'll see here that basically what I see on this screen is nearly exactly the same thing that I saw on the original screen. It doesn't, however, import the wood grain, and it doesn't give me the clear material on my fuel cell down here, but you'll see that for the most part it looks about the same. It is a 3D model, and if I click and drag with my mouse, I can reposition this and I can see my little airplane engine from all directions. And it does have those views that I created here as well. So my default view, my front view, my right side view, my rear view, and so on. There's also down here in this lower right hand corner the ability to see all of the different parts. This is part of the assembly template. So as I come through here, I can see there's the crankcase, the crankshaft itself, the connecting rod, the piston, and so on. If I want to isolate any of those objects and just look at them one at a time, I can choose isolate here, And then you'll see here now that I've got my piston, okay, and it's isolated it so I can turn it around and I can look at what that piston is going to look like as well. If I want to get back all of the parts, I can choose that. Or if I wanted to pick, for example, just one of the parts and hide it so that you couldn't see it, you know, I could come in here and I could say, let's look at the cylinder head, okay, or that cylinder right there. I can say, let's hide that part. And so now I can see what it looks like without that cylinder in place. So it gives us lots of flexibility. A couple other things that don't quite work for Inventor the way you would hope they would be, we have this ability to come in here and create a cross section. I'm going to set up my cross section properties. And the thing that I want to do is I'm going to cut this on the X axis so that it's going down the length of the object here, or down the length of the engine. I can say that I want to show the intersections. That's the red lines. I can show the cutting plane or not. I'll turn that off just so that you get kind of a white background again. And then I could come in and I could say ignore selected parts or whatever. But if I just say okay, let's just close this right now, you'll see here that I've got actually kind of what looks like a cross section. So you can kind of see, you know, where the piston is and the connecting rod, you know, coming down here to the bottom. But it's not perfect, because if you look closely, you'll see that what it has actually created is a surface model. So even though this is solid material, it only shows me the surfaces itself. It doesn't show me the actual objects as solid objects. So it's not quite exactly what I want, but at least it's better than nothing. A couple other things that you can do is you can come in here and you can say, I want to print these different model views. So I can say, I want to print them all, or I want to only print certain selected ones. And as you hover over each one, it gives you, you know, the different, what that's going to look like. Okay. And it does have the base views here. So I've got, again, front, back, top, bottom, left side, and right side. Okay, and then a couple different isometrics as well. So however you think you might want to use these, it's all great. And again, it is a spectacular way of sharing your designs with people who do not have Autodesk Inventor.